welcome to today's episode of your At Home Fitness. We're going to go ahead and jump into getting warmed up and mobilized and joints a little bit limber. So let's go ahead, feet under those hips to start. Go ahead, send those hips back toward the wall, and you're going to start out just by touching your toes and then standing nice and tall.
Reach hips back, and
they have a dog next door.
And
you complained about me being sidetracked.
And reach.
And stand.
You're talking about birds.
Move through that a little bit faster. And up. And back. And up. Not that fast.
Oh.
And back.
Just kidding.
Three more. Hips back. Last two. And last one. Go ahead and walk those feet out. Wider stance. Reach opposite left hand down to the right side. And reach opposite. Continue to send those hips back toward the wall. Get a nice stretch in those hammies.
Three, four.
We're going to do two more each side. And one. And go ahead and walk your feet in underneath those hips. Reach down, touch those toes. Walk it on out into a plank position. Go ahead and set those feet a little bit wide. You're going to bring your right knee into your chest, send weight forward, and then rock back and press straight back and up. And rock forward, press back, and forward, and back. Three more, forward, back, last two, back, last one, and back. Foot comes down, opposite side. Knee in, press back, in, four more, and two, and one, and down, feet down. Go ahead, bring your left leg up outside that right one, and step back, and alternate, and back, and alternate, back. And back. Left leg comes on up straight in the air, nice long lines. Head through the window. You're going to swing that left leg through and outside that left foot. Drop that back knee down to the ground. Push your hip flexor into the floor. Go ahead, drop your right hip toward the floor. Reach and twist toward the sky. And back down the center, and you're going to walk those hands away 45. Back to the middle reset. Go ahead and tuck that toe under, knee off the ground, and step your left one back. Right leg comes on up in the air, nice long line, head through the window, and swing that right side on through. Drop your back knee down to the ground. Press your hip flexor into the floor. Walk that left hand in, drop that outside hip, and reach and twist toward the ceiling. Back to the middle, walk those hands away 45. To the center. Tuck your back toe under and step that left one back and then come on down to a tabletop position. Bring your left knee into your chest. Give me three big circles. Knee in. Draw that circle around. Left side, fire hydrant out and down. Keep those hips nice and square to the floor. Three and four. Four more. Last two, and last one. Knee in, long line, press straight back, and in, and back. You got six more reps. Four, last two, last one. Bend that heel toward the sky, and pulse, 10, 9, 8, 5, 3, 2, One, reset center. Reset that weight. Right knee comes into your chest and draw three big circles out and around. Knee down, fire hydrant out for eight. Seven, last one. Knee comes in, long line, straight back and in. Two, three. Six, two more. Last one, bend at the heel, heel to the sky, pulse 10. Seven, five, four, three, two, and one. Good. For today's workout, you're going to need yourself your weights, either your single or double. Go ahead, if you do have two options, you're gonna bring those out. Also, if you have a bench or an ottoman in your living room, something that you can lean on that's a flat surface, will work as well. Go ahead, grab your equipment, and we'll meet you right back. Part A, we have three movements for you guys. We're gonna start out our first movement with a front foot elevated lunge. One foot's gonna be up on that weight, back one nice and wide. Now we're gonna take this at tempo, so we're gonna be going down for 2 seconds with no hold at the bottom, and then up for 2 seconds. So it's just a nice, slow, consistent move throughout that whole range of motion. Really make sure that we're dropping straight down for that lunge versus driving that knee forward over that ankle. Just nice straight down, straight up, nice and slow. We're gonna do 6 reps per side. You do have the option of holding a weight as well, whether it's in a goblet position up front, or if you wanna follow Becca, she's gonna have one weight on either side of her hands. So let's go ahead, get that foot up on that weight to start. Set up that nice stance back. Weight nice and tall. We got 6 reps on this first leg. Here we go. And down, two, and up. One, down, two, and up. Two, down, two, and up. Three, down, two, up. Four, down, two, up. Five, down, two, and up. Six. Go ahead, switch which foot is forward. We got 6 reps on the other side. And down, two, and up. One, down, two, and up, two. If lunges are hard for you on those knees, you're just gonna reduce that range of motion slightly and take it down just to your comfort level. There's four, two more. You got one more. Down, two, and rest. Ooh. Weights are gonna come down by your side. Our second movement is gonna be a plank shoulder tap. We can either do these from a plank position, hips and pelvis are gonna be tucked underneath your body, reaching opposite arm to shoulder, really working on keeping those shoulders nice and square to the ground. That's a tough position for you. You can take those knees down to the ground as well in order to do that plank, okay? Now still make sure you have a nice straight line from that shoulder to those knees. We don't want any booty sticking back in that process if we are doing those from the knee. We got 12 reps total, so it's gonna be 6 on each side. Here we go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 11, and 12. Movement number 3 is gonna be a lawnmower row. You have the option to do these standing, or if you have a support that you can lean on, you can do that as well. If you do have support, it's gonna be same arm and knee on the bench. So nice strong pull like you're cranking the chain on a lawnmower, in with elbows in those back pockets. We're gonna be doing 8 per side on that. If you don't have support or anything to hold on to, you're just gonna do a staggered stance, using your forearm for support, bending that knee slightly to the ground. Same thing, pulling in, elbows in those back pockets on that pull, coming down as far as you can. So we don't want to overreach and drop, right? But keep those shoulders nice and square to the ground. This
Usually we're raging.
Here we go. We got 8 reps on that right side to start. And pull. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Last one. Good. Go ahead, switch that stance. Set up that base and support. 8 reps on the opposite side. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Last 2. And 8. Good. We're taking it back to those top for those front foot elevated lunges.
These weights are slicker than the books we normally use.
I know.
We're going to get ready to have the blue for real in a hot second.
The textbook on a hill was in the grass
was more secure than this. Wait, I am on the verge of getting ready to do a split.
Here we go. 6 reps. And down, 2, up, 2, down, 2, and up, 2, down, 2, and up, 3, down, 2, up, 4, 2 more, down, 2, 5, last one, 2, and up, there's 6. Opposite foot forward. Here we go, 6 reps. Down, 2, up, 1, down, 2, up, 2, 2, and up. 3, get a nice full range of motion if you can. 4, 2 more. Last one. Down. 2, and up, there's 6. Back down to the ground for those shoulder taps. Set that feet raised nice and wide, tuck hips and pelvis under. You got 12 reps. 2, 4, 8, 11, and 12. Same side leg in support if you have that bench or box. Otherwise, go ahead and set your base. We got 8 reps for that pull.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 5, 7, and 8. Opposite side, here we go. And 1, 2, 3. Keep that back nice and flat. 6, 7, and 8. Going back to the top. We got one more set for that combo.
I know, the nerve, but nerve.
Front foot up on that weight. Set up that base. Here we go. 6 reps. And down. 2. Up. 1. 2. 2. Keep that torso nice and upright. 3. 4. 2 more. 5. Last one. And up, there's 6. Ready? 6 reps. Down. two, one, two, two, three, four. There's five, last one. And six. Hands underneath those shoulders, wide base of those feet. 12 taps. One. Round forward and collapse, but stay nice and active. Press booty back and belly button to the floor. Here we go, 8 reps. 8 reps. One, two, three, five, seven, last one, and 8. Ooh. Go ahead and hold onto your weight. You're going to push whatever you are using to keep your foot elevated on and off to the side. You can put that bench on and off to the side as well. Grab yourself a drink of water, and we're going to get going in part B here in just a minute. For your Metcalf for today, we have 3 movements. It's going to be 30 seconds of work with 30 seconds of rest, and we're going to do 4 sets total through the whole thing. Your first movement is going to be a devil's press. So depending on if you have 1 weight or 2 weights, it'll look somewhat similar. So Becca's going to show you with 2 weights. She's going to come on down to a push-up position to the ground, then she's going to jump those feet up, swing those weights through her hips, and straight overhead in 1 movement. We do want these to be somewhat like a snatch and nice smooth movement overhead, versus stopping at the shoulder before you press. Okay? If you have a single weight, you're gonna still do your push-up, jump, one side through, and press. You're gonna switch on the way down, and then just switch hands with each of your reps over the course of your 30 seconds. So that's gonna be movement number one. Movement number two, we're gonna do prisoner reverse lunges. Hands are gonna be behind your head with those reverse lunges. Stepping back, working a nice four-inch motion to the floor, opening that hip at the top for every movement. If you do have any knee issues or reduced range of motion, you can just step back and flex that knee as far as what's comfortable for you for that lunge. Movement number three is a plank jack. You're going to be down in a plank position, hands underneath the shoulders, and you're going to dip your feet out and in, out and in. Becca's still keeping her hips and pelvis somewhat tucked under in that process. She's not letting her booty rise and stick toward the ceiling, but a nice, straight, beautiful, long plank as she moves.
Thank you, ma'am. That was hard to do.
Woo! Now you're bourbon.
Yeah, right?
Cool!
Are we ready to rock and roll?
Ready.
Sweet, we're gonna pair with the music just a smidge.
Bye, Erin.
Yep.
Thank you. Drive through those heels. Keep that dumbbell nice and close to your body. 10 more seconds. And 5, 3, 2, 1, and rest.
Halfway.
Halfway.
10 to go. 5, 3, 1, and time. Woo! Good work, guys. Go ahead, grab yourself some water. Meet on back for a little cool down and mobilization.
If you guys aren't already on the floor for your cool down and mobilization, go ahead and find yourself a spot on the floor. Join us on down here. We're going to go ahead and start with that left leg forward. You're going to tuck that right one in. And go ahead and reach down toward that toe. Get a nice stretch on the outside. Or collapse leg. Flexi girl over here.
Oh, sorry.
She's got like multiple superpowers.
It's not true. Have you seen Jordan? Jordan is flexi.
Oh my gosh. She just like flop herself nicely.
Yeah, we see her.
Props out to Jordan for her flexi, flexiness.
She's impressive.
And then you're going to go ahead and take those hands. You're going to walk them all the way around to the outside of that knee. Hands on the floor. Give yourself a nice little twist. So firm contact on the floor. Keep your bum down toward the ground. And twist and rotate behind you. I mean, you aren't actually going to twist and rotate.
I was like, I can't get back any further.
So there are limits on your superpowers and flexibility.
I mean, if you want my butt to stay on the ground, I mean, I can twist, but I don't think that's really doing much for my spine at that point.
Come on back to the center and just collapse forward. Good. Roll on up. You're going to extend that opposite leg. Reach toward that toe to start. And then go ahead and take your hands, walk them all the way around outside of that knee. Contact the floor and twist and pull your body behind you. And come on back to the center, collapse forward. And roll it on up. Go ahead and keep that same one extended. Now you're gonna pick it up and cross it over. And big bear hug into your chest. Should feel a nice stretch down the outside of that glute. And now you're going to rotate that shin parallel with the ground and like a baby hug. So reach around the bottom of your sole of your foot and then around the outside of your quad. Go ahead and release, but put that sole of your foot down on the ground. Take your straight leg, bend that one under, and then go ahead and stitch your hips back down on the ground. So I want hips nice and square, flat on the ground, not up in the air, but booty down, and hug to start. And then take those hands and walk them around the outside. You can use that elbow to get a little leverage on that extra twist. Go ahead and gently unwind. You need your opposite leg straight. Top one crosses over to start. Big bear hug in. It's the same thing. We're keeping those hips on the ground. You don't want to let that hip pick up or lift, but big bear hug. Now go ahead and turn your shin horizontal. So reach around the bottom of that sole of that foot, around the outside of your quad, and look like a baby.
Try and sit that torso nice and upright, so don't lean back in that process, but sink both those butt cheeks down on the ground. Gently release, foot comes to the ground, tuck that straight one under. And then sit those hips back again. You're gonna start with that hug. And then go ahead and walk those hands to the outside using your elbow for leverage, gently twist. And unwind. Keep that bottom one tucked under. You're gonna swing that top one around all the way to the back and come on into a pigeon position. So square hips to the ground, roll that hip down toward the floor. You can go ahead and walk it all the way down to the floor, resting forehead to the backs of your hands. Hands under those shoulders, come on back up. We're gonna add in a foot grab to this position, so this hand's gonna reach back. I feel like stretch across from my kneecap.
That's not bad.
Oh, thanks.
I felt my quad.
Well, it's like lower quad, like okay. Super lower quad, top of kneecap. Walk it down to the floor, forehead to the backs of your palms. Hands underneath the shoulders, gently press up. And we're gonna add in the foot grab again. Gentle. She's all fancy over there, like balancing on one side.
Don't make me fall.
And gently release. Okay. Okay, knees nice and wide. You're going to put your toes together. So you're walking knees out and wide, toes together.
I might cry during this one. This one.
This was also by your request.
I know, but I'm all flattered.
We're going to start with those hands underneath those shoulders. Just sink those hips into the ground. And then shift your weight back toward your heels. And weight comes forward a little bit. Walk your hands out a little bit in front of your body. You can come on down to those forearms.
That's for getting back at you. This kind of hurts my knees on this floor.
Ooh, it's not. I feel my knees.
something under my knee.
The graceful gazelle fails.
Oh, yeah. What?
Ooh. Hands back underneath the
I just floor. Got here.
Ow. Okay, we'll come out the easy way. Down on his belly. Relax those feet. Oh, look, you were perfect in the perfect okay, position. Great. Finish off with some scorpion here. Hands out in a T position to the side. You're going to do 10 alternating touches to start out. No, you could go. Yeah, otherwise we're going
to. I kind of wanted to touch your foot. So
oh, cute. 3, 4. 4 more. On this last one, hold here. And reach overhead. And back down to the center, kick opposite one back, and then add in that reach to finish off. Reach and overhead.
No, thanks.
And back down. Well, great work today, guys. Hope you've enjoyed today's episode of your At Home Fitness. And we'll see y'all back here tomorrow.
Yeah.
Have a good one.